Rush Limbaugh catches Moore's accuser in huge lie, instantly proves his innocence. On Tuesday, infamous radio host Rush Limbaugh discussed the alleged sexual assault of Beverly Young Nelson by Alabama GOP Senate candidate Roy Moore in 1977. Limbaugh appears to have caught Nelson in a huge lie, which proves Moore's innocence. This changes everything. According to Nelson, she was waiting tables in 1977, when her boyfriend didn't show up to give her a ride home after her shift. Roy Moore allegedly offered to give her a ride but instead took her to a dark, deserted area of a parking lot, where he began to grope her and tried to force her head onto his crotch, CNN reported. Nelson claims that she was unable to escape the car when Moore gave her a ride one evening because the doors were locked and she could not unlock them from the inside. However, Limbaugh found this version of events to be problematic for one reason in particular. Alabama Senate candidate Roy Moore is denying that he ever met the woman who on Monday accused him of sexually assaulting her in a diner parking lot in 1977 when she was an underage teenager, calling her allegations absolutely false, despite his apparent signature in her high school yearbook, said Limbaugh. This is 1977? Somebody tell me, in 1977, were there child locks on the door? Asked the radio host. In other words, could the driver push a button that would make sure all windows and doors could not be opened? Was that present in 1977, because she says she couldn't get out? But did child locks, were they in 1977 vehicles? Limbaugh furthered. I'm trying to remember what I had in 1977. I had a Pontiac. Well, it was a pretty big Pontiac. The car I had didn't have them in there. But I didn't drive every car that's out there. You know, the button on the driver's side where you can flip it and nobody can open a door, Limbaugh continued. It's to protect kids from opening windows and doors when the car is moving, Limbaugh explained. But if that wasn't present, he then apparently received confirmation that it wasn't until the 1980s that car manufacturers began installing child safety locks in vehicles. They've been in the automobile since the early 80s, said Limbaugh. Cars began to be built with a child lock feature in the early 80s, he reiterated. So it might be safe to assume that the door she was sitting next to she could have unlocked it, unless Roy Moore had a special custom lock called the female anti-escape lock on the passenger side of the front seat of his car, he concluded sarcastically. Does this prove unequivocally that Roy Moore is innocent? His opponents will say it does not. However, it adds to the already mounting evidence that seems to show his accusers may be fabricating their stories. It remains of the utmost importance that we allow all of the facts of this case to come out before passing judgment on a man who has been completely above reproach up until this point in his career.